I'm actually a really shy person. And I'm really uncomfortable with people judging me and looking at me.
I don't want to be that. I don't want to do that. I don't want to let it get to my head. I don't want to do, you know, let it get too overwhelming where I get like anxious and have anxiety all the time.
When I got to college, I was a football player, so I was still in a family. I still felt like it was home. It was a second family. But when I made the next step and got into the NFL and I was by myself, that's when my social anxiety really showed its ugly head. And you know, being a number one draft pick, Heisman Trophy winner, the center of attention, from the outside, you know, people expected me to be the happiest person in the world. I had achieved my dream, but internally, I was struggling.
You know, 10 years ago, if I saw a video on social anxiety, I would just think it's an experience. I would think the more people meet more people, the more they become easy and natural meeting people, because that's what it feels like, right? You become good at what you do again and again and again. It would be kind of surprising to believe that celebrities could have social anxiety, because they're meeting so many people, they're interacting with so many people, they're engaging with audience all the time. But it's interesting because people who have social anxiety, the more celebrity they become, the more intense that anxiety becomes. So in this particular case, doing more of it, meeting more people, doesn't seem to solve the challenge. You have celebrities like footballers, you have movie stars who have actually eventually quit their career and stepped out of their career because they have social anxiety. And what is interesting is today, it appears like there is no solution to social anxiety other than some painful methods that take weeks together, and people rather would quit their career than go through painful therapeutic processes.
I've been a musician for more than 10 to 15 years. Every time I would go out and perform at some competition or some stage where I'm just doing what I do, I feel really great while doing it, but when I come off the stage and when people are approaching me and when they want to compliment me, I just feel a little bit awkward and I strain away from connecting with them. And that's when I realized I had this issue of being anxious around a lot of people in general. And because of that, it has lost me a lot of connections which I could have had with, you know, other budding artists and other people who would want to collab with me. And that's been one of the greatest losses. So it was my first time being in a new place in Delhi. And it was my first time attending up with a lot of people around. And immediately my social anxiety was at its peak.
On stage, I'm not going to be speaking to people. I'm just going to perform my art. And I know that people are going to be fascinated by it because it's kind of new. Mm-hmm. But when I come back down and like, I won't be able to like even take up appreciations from people when I come down from stage and people are like, you did good. Mm-hmm. And I'll be like, cool, okay, fine.
Okay, come up here.
When I came down the stage and when people came and approached me to compliment me, I didn't feel awkward at all. I was in fact so happy to talk to them. I was happy to know what they had to say about my performance and know from them, like, and connect with them truly and deeply and not just say, you know, like, thank you and be okay with it. So that was one of the biggest significance I saw as soon as I finished the procedure and I came down. As soon as I came back, I wanted to perform and see the change. And I did notice it. And when I was performing, I was not worried about how it's going to be when I'm done and when I go meet people. But I was just having fun. And when the performance was done, I came down, I connected with people. They were like, Kevin, you look really different right now. Something has changed. I don't know what that is. And that is when I realized at that point, no matter how many people are around me, no matter like if I'm around 1,000 or like 10,000 people, Kevin is not going to feel anxious. He's still going to have that 100% potential, and he's going to do what he wants to do and gets things done right there. That's been my journey so far, and it's been there. Even when I'm not performing, this social anxiety has been completely eradicated in my other spheres of life as well. So that's how beautiful this change has been.
So what you've seen in this video is considered impossible in the world. Kevin got over a social anxiety, and which would have crippled him the more he grew in his career, because the pattern of social anxiety is it becomes more intense when you actually grow more and you have more opportunities to interact with people. And in this video, you see how Kevin got over it in a few minutes. A lot of people ask me, is it really possible to get over challenges like this in minutes when the rest of the world feels it's impossible to change? Is it really possible that someone who's stuck with the habit for decades together can change in minutes? And my obvious answer to most of them is that, well, it's actually possible for people to change in a moment. So people change in the moment, and an existence installation specialist can design and create this moment. So a specialist is able to take someone into an altered state in a normal conversation and in a moment help them make life trajectory shifting changes within that person. And for a lot of people, we tell them that learning how to create breakthroughs for people in minutes is the prerequisite, it's the building block, it's the basic fundamental space necessary that you need to have as a capability for you even to start the journey of existence installations. So yes, it's possible. And a lot more is possible in the world, and that's the good news. There is more things possible in the world for you, for your family, and for everyone, if you can find it.